Hello, so I'm Serge Lacourte, CEO of Scaleagent, and I will give you some news of Joram. First, some yes, this is a PDF version. So first, some reminders about Joram, which is an open source message-oriented middleware, which is compliant to the standard JMS, which will be compliant to the quite new standard AMQP 1.0. In 2013, Joram is very efficient, and we have some measures, of course, on Joram, and we have published a new tool so that you are able to perform your own measurements. Joram is supported by Scaleagent, and Joram is particularly configurable and extensible. Joram is a mature project. We release 2 to 3 versions a year, and we have regularly changed the internal architecture. Basically, it relies on a truly distributed architecture so that it may scale quite easily. Joram is used in various operational contexts. I've cited here France Telecom as a message-oriented middleware in the information system besides MQ series from IBM. It is used by the CNES, which is a French special agency for a monitoring and control system, by the French Home Office for the management of car certificates, and also in a more specific context, for example, as a base for an RFID middleware. So this is a picture of the Joram users community from the downloads. So you can see it is quite spread all over the world. And our offer on Joram is the usual technical support offering on extensions on Joram. And what's new is that we want to move to a freemium model. So I'm quite ready to discuss it with you if you like, for the reasons and so on. And it's really a freemium and not an open core model. Joram will remain open source and will continue to evolve as it has until now. And we want to provide additional tools and services to facilitate the life of the Joram user. So we have identified 4 items of work. We will polish the integration of Joram with other environments, and notably Talend here. We have 2 consoles, one for the developer and one for the operational. And we have the MQPerf tool, which is provided as a service. Okay, so this is a freemium model. Joram will remain open source, so you can still use Joram as you like. And we provide all the tools and services as an annual subscription. That is, in between, I would say, a proprietary model with a license per processor or per server. Here we provide a global licensing for a project. And a project is identified as a single terminal application. And that application may, of course, be distributed because Joram, the base of Joram, is to be distributed. Okay. So I will explain our new offer based on a simple use case. You are an IT director and you are using MQ Series from IBM. And you are tempted by Joram because it will reduce your license cost. You need to move because your application is aging, and anyway you have to redevelop it, or you want to add new functions. And it's a good opportunity to switch to Joram. So why choose Joram? So I said, of course, you have the incentive of license cost. It's incremental. That is, we do not wish you to move MQ Series outside of your information system. Actually, Joram is quite compatible with MQ Series. France Telecom has done it on some projects. And of course, what we provide here is that with the tools and services of Joram MQ, which is the name of our new offer, that will help you to do that move. So the first question, does Joram actually, or can Joram actually do the work? So you can check with what is written about Joram, about the functionalities and about the performance. But we believe that a real test with your machine and with Joram on your machine is the best to convince you. So we have provided this tool, which is called MQ Perf. With this tool, you can actually download Joram on your machine, perform all performance tests according to a set, to a panel of scenarios, and you have the best performance possible by Joram on your machine. So it's not only paperwork. So when you have figures such as those ones that I have obtained on my laptop, you know it is possible with a standard version of Joram. Okay, so it's not not figures as you can see on some MOM providers. So you can rely on those figures, so that reduce the risk you may take on a migration project. At the early defined phase, when you work with a MOM, you have a strong decision to make, architectural decisions, and those impact both the service you get and the performance you get. So when you work with a new MOM, you can you can test on hope that you are testing directly the good solution, or you can with MQPerf, with the MQPerf standard, which is the second service of MQPerf, you can analyze how Joram behaves under stress conditions. So we'll provide here detailed curves of key Joram indicators to show you how Joram behaves under continuous stress. And this helps choosing the best configuration of your application using Joram. Then in the development phase, of course, you have to launch Joram to perform some tests and also to debug when something goes wrong. And here we provide a specific console dedicated to the developer, which gives you access to MOM-specific indicators. They are based on the GMX indicators that are available in Joram, but you have a MOM-dedicated presentation on direct access. Okay. And then we provide an operator's console, so which provides very simple indicators that can be integrated in a standard console such as Nagios. So my conclusion is that Joram is a great middleware that do its jobs. We propose you new tools to facilitate your usage of Joram, so that you will be able to do your project in better conditions, more quickly, and with better confidence. Thank you.